So this video is just a little bit different of taking you outside here with me. I'm going to ask you a very crucial question here. What are you going to eat? What are you going to eat? Hey, ihr Lieben. It's Yeshua here, yeshuabeuten.com. Usually I'm not making content about food and stuff. I'm not starting a cooking channel now. I actually make content about helping you growing in faith, experiencing the gospel, and encouraging you to walk it out daily. And in this video, I do want to touch on what you're going to eat, but not necessarily the delicious physical food, but the spiritual food that God has for us. Let's look at Psalms 23 verse 5, where it says, "You prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemy. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over." When I read this, I had to think of Jesus and his lifestyle and his ministry. Everywhere he went, he was walking in signs, wonders, and miracles. His table was really prepared, like literally everything he wanted or needed in this moment for others, for himself, it was there. God was providing. But it was in the presence of his enemies. Everywhere he went and stuff happened, the enemy was almost like wanting to kill him, right? But like the Pharisees, for example. But they couldn't because they feared the people. So then when it came to the time that Jesus had to go to the cross, even there, right, the table was prepared in front of him. He could any time, he could have said, "Nope, not happening. I don't want this whole, you know, cross thing. I don't want to die. Not for him, not for her. I'm not doing this." Nope. He could have chosen the table. He could have said, "You know what? I'm going to paradise. I'm not having this here." But he didn't. In that moment, he chose the enemy in front of him, before him, where he allowed the enemy to kill him, to crucify him. But we all know that on the third day he resurrected, he rose again, so that we, you and I, could have a chance that we could also partake from the table prepared before us. See, 2,000 years ago, he made it possible for you and for me to have a relationship with the Father again. He made it possible for you and for me to basically eat from the spiritual fruit, so to speak, that God had in place, that God had prepared for us, but that were blocked off because of our sin, because of our sinful, selfish ways. Now, Jesus died for you and for me so that we could be reconciled with Father God again, that we would not have to suffer hell and hell fire, but would have eternal life if we would choose Jesus and if we would choose his forgiveness that he prepared on the cross. But there's another crucial thing that Jesus did for you and for me. He faced the enemy once and for all to win the battle, to win the victory, not just the battle, but the victory for you and for me, so that now we also could face the enemy with the victory mindset and in the authority of victory, in Jesus' authority. Because he died for you and for me so that we could have life and life eternally, so that we could step in and fight the enemy. The enemy who goes around like a roaring lion, who pretends to be a lion, but actually is just a mouse with a microphone. He's not a big deal. He might seem like a big deal. Cancer might seem like a big deal. Severe sicknesses or real family troubles and real struggles of life, they seem like a big deal. They are. But that's only what we feel and what, yes, we see. But the reality of God is a prepared table where there is healing, deliverance, restoration, and more so, salvation. So the question is, what are you going to eat of? Are you going to eat of what the enemy has, or are you going to eat of what God has for you? I like to pray for you, especially for the ones that maybe go through stuff. I want to pray for you for healing, for deliverance. And if you would, just open your heart for the Holy Spirit to come and to minister to you right now. Father, I ask you that you would touch the people right now listening. In Jesus' name, I come against any struggle, any sickness and disease, especially sickness and disease. I bind and break it right now. I command it to leave in Jesus' name. God, I thank you for deliverance right now. I release it right now. God, I thank you that you touch the person right now listening. Thank you, Father. Thank you that you fill Holy Spirit. I thank you, God, that you give new vision and new hope. God, I thank you that you would let us see the table prepared and especially the items you have put on the table for us, Father, for us, that you paid your precious blood for, that you bled and shed your precious blood for. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Guys, always remember, share this video and the gospel with a friend. God bless you. There's a spider there. Oh my goodness, I didn't even see that one. That one is an ugly fella. Ugh. There's another spider. Gosh. They're everywhere. Ugh.